Let's start this bulletin with our top story that WION is tracking at the moment. Coronavirus comes to India. India's health minister, Dr. Harsh Vardhan, has confirmed 28 cases of coronavirus in India, out of which 25 people are currently infected. The Delhi man infected with coronavirus has further infected 6 family members. A group of 17 people travelling from Italy, including 16 Italian nationals and 1 Indian, have been infected. Those who came in contact with the man infected in Telangana are still being tested.
अभी जो मेरे पास जानकारी है उसके हिसाब से इनका टोटल 28 होता है इस 28 में मैंने आपको ब्रॉड बताया कि 3 लोग केरल में आए थे ठीक हो गए एक दिल्ली में आया वो ट्रैवल करके आया इटली से जो जिसने अपने 6 रिश्तेदारों को इन्फेक्ट करा एक इटालियन ग्रुप जो ट्रैवलिंग के लिए भारत में आया था उस ग्रुप के जो है 16 इटालियन और उसको जो चला रहा था ड्राइवर एक इंडियन वो इन्फेक्ट हुआ उस ग्रुप के अंदर जो है तो दैट इज द एग्जैक्ट नंबर राइट नाउ लगभग 3000 से ज्यादा हम लोग टेस्ट कर चुके हैं जिसमें ये जो पॉजिटिव्स हैं इनके बारे में आपको बता दिया 15 लेबोरेटरीज हमने पहले एस्टैब्लिश की थी फर्स्ट फेज में ही अभी 19 लेबोरेटरीज और एस्टैब्लिश कर दी हैं जिसमें से 7-8 कल शुरू हो गई बाकी सब आज शुरू हो जाए
And now for more updates on the matter, our principal diplomatic correspondent Sidhan Sibyl is joining us live. Sidhan, tell us, we just heard from the health minister, he briefed the entire country. How prepared or equipped really is India to fight this outbreak?
Well, I'm standing in front of India's health ministry and we know that the Indian government has been taking measures since January, whether it is not giving visas in a sense, visa on arrival being cancelled from the most affected countries, especially from China. And of course, a new advisory being issued by the Indian government just yesterday when it comes to countries like Japan, Iran, Italy, because these are the first affected countries outside of China. Now, we also know that the Indian government has updated the figures of the number of people impacted or infected by the coronavirus and number has jumped substantially in just 24 hours from just no cases just a few weeks ago till 9 Indians being infected as of now even as we speak with this virus they have been isolated and we also know that 16 Italians have been infected with this virus as well the group of the Italian tourists had come to Jaipur in February last week of February and one of the Italians fell ill after which testing was done and it was confirmed that he has the virus The group was brought to Delhi. They are right now in a quarantine camp in Chawla, which is an ITBP camp. The people infected from the group, 21 Italians were in the group, plus the driver, plus the conductor and the tour guide. Out of 21 Italians, 16 are now confirmed having this virus. The toll has substantially jumped in India. We have seen the Indian Prime Minister also tweeting about it, saying that there is no need to panic. He has also said that he will not take part in the Holi festival. Along with him, other members of the ruling BJP party has also said that they are not going to participate in any Holi Milan festival because right. gatherings are something that can help in spreading of this virus. But by and large, the government has been saying that they are taking a lot of measures. The big question is, as the toll jumps, what will be the further measures announced by the Indian government, especially when it comes to medicines and masks?
Right. Siddhant, as we know, the WHO has warned of a global shortage in protective equipment. What about India? Do we have enough supplies when it comes to protective masks or sanitizers? We hear that people are scrambling to buy these necessities.
Well, yesterday the DGFT had announced that the key ingredients required for the medicines when it comes to this virus, the export of key ingredients are now considered banned. The ban came to effect yesterday midnight. We also know that the Indian government has been saying that there is no shortages of masks, but we also have been speaking to people here on the ground, especially in the national capital, where the medicine shops are saying that the prices have jumped. This is something that has been a cause of concern for the common man here in the national capital. In fact, this was a question which was asked at the briefing which took place inside the health ministry, which is behind me, to the health minister, to which he said that they are going to take strict action against people who are trying to make sure that the prices might increase, or hoarding the masks, which are right now a necessity in the capital and of course across the country. So the government has been saying that they will take measures against anyone who is found in indulging in activities that can be causing problems to the common when it comes to dealing with this crisis. But as of now, we know that there can be certain shortages when it comes to masks.
Right, Siddhant. Now, the health minister has deterred people against mass gatherings. So what lies ahead for institutions like schools? We know that it's exam season and parents are wondering, should they be sending their kids to schools? So is there any update on that?
Well, there is no official advisory when it comes to schools. We know that three schools have been closed down in India, in the Delhi suburb, which is Noida. We also know that officially the advisory is not expected to come, but informally the government has said that avoid mass gathering. And the fact that the Indian Prime Minister has tweeted that he is not going to take part in Holi, which is all about mass gathering, that sends a message that avoid mass gathering, avoid public functions. But the government does not want to bring out an advisory because that might cause panic in the country, in the capital city. So do not expect an advisory coming soon, but as of now there is informal advisory that avoid big gatherings, gatherings where the spread of the virus can happen.
All right, Siddhant, thank you for those insights, and reminder to our viewers that WION will continue to bring you all the live updates as and when we know more about coronavirus and the measures on ground. And now, as coronavirus has resurfaced in India and the number of cases are on the rise, here are a few things that people must remember. Indian citizens are advised to refrain from travel to China. People traveling to China will be quarantined on return. It is also advised to refrain from non-essential travel to Singapore, South Korea, Iran and Italy. India has suspended visas and e-visas of nationals from Italy, Iran, South Korea and Japan. For any queries related to health, people may contact the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Their helpline numbers and email ID, which is currently on your screen. This helpline number and email is operational 24/7. We urge people to follow protocol and disclose if they have contracted coronavirus. We also urge people to not ignore the symptoms. Coronavirus has spread across 77 countries in a matter of just a few weeks. Not revealing cases or not seeking medical help at a time like this might have catastrophic ramifications.